Individuals and peace organizations are coming out in force and expressing opposition to renewed U.S. bombing in North Vietnam. The National Peace Action Coalition, quiet since its last anti-war demonstration in Washington on November 18th produced a little interest, has announced plans for new massive demonstrations in the capital on Inauguration Day. Jerry Gordon, a national coordinator for the group, told a news conference today that President Nixon, in Gordon's words, has utter contempt for human life and is prepared to bomb, kill, and maim without limit until the Vietnamese capitulate to U.S. demands. He called for a massive outcry from the American people at Nixon's inauguration for his second term on January 20th. Anti-war labor leaders making up the Labor for Peace group asked the Senate Foreign Relations Committee to investigate the delay in peace settlement for Vietnam and the stepped-up bombing. And an organization of families of American prisoners of war charges that President Nixon is sacrificing the lives of American POWs by bombing areas in which prison camps are located. The White House says the massive bombing over Hanoi and Haiphong will continue, despite reports from Hanoi that American prisoners of war have been injured in the air raids. Presidential News Secretary Ron Ziegler says the North Vietnamese are to blame if the POWs were hurt as reported. Ziegler pointed out that under the terms of the Geneva Agreement, internees must be kept out of areas subject to military attack. The North Vietnamese in Paris said the prisoners are kept in camps in populated areas near embassies, and the U.S. command is slanderous. The president met with Henry Kissinger and his aide, Major General Alexander Haig, for 2 hours today. Nixon also conferred with Kissinger twice by phone before the chief peace negotiator flew to Washington for the holiday weekend, as did Haig. While meeting with Nixon at the Florida White House, Haig delivered a note from South Vietnam's President Tu, the contents of which were not disclosed. The U.S. command in Saigon reports the loss of another two B-52 bombers over North Vietnam, bringing to 8 the number of big bombers lost since the beginning of the week. At least 43 American pilots are listed as missing. CBS correspondent Bert Quince went to one of the B-52 bases in Thailand to find out how the crewmen feel about their new mission.
The men who fly the B-52 aren't happy about the new danger they find themselves in, but many believe their missions over Hanoi are a good idea. Utapao Air Force Base in Thailand is the place that many of the big bombers set out from. Normally, it's off-limits to newsmen. Tonight, because Bob Hope was giving a show for the men there, we were permitted on the base to report on it. Military information officers were on hand to make sure we didn't do much talking with the bomber crew and that we discussed nothing but the show and Christmas. But it was obvious that the men continued a particularly rough Christmas. They did a lot of laughing, but Captains Jack Tom, Bill Miller, and Jim Grace didn't sound all that merry. How's Christmas shaping up?
Over here, you gotta be kidding.
There is Eddie over here.
How are things going? You guys feeling pretty up or pretty down right about now?
Yeah. Other crewmen, when the microphones and information officers weren't present, were blunt about the intense bombing of Hanoi. We could have done this 6 years ago, one said. Another added, it's better than bombing the monkeys in the jungle.
Reports from Paris indicate American planes bombing Hanoi are falling prey to a new type of surface-to-air missile, but Saigon sources deny this. Nonetheless, the toll on American planes has been severe. Hanoi claims to have shot down 34 U.S. warplanes in the 5 days of saturation bombing north of the 20th parallel. The Strato Fortresses also flew missions over South Vietnam today, south of the DMZ in the Central Highlands and near Saigon. But the entire Navy fleet of warplanes stationed on carriers in the Tonkin Gulf concentrated on the Hanoi-Haiphong area. Vietnamese sources in Saigon say President Nguyen Van Thieu has agreed to be flexible on signing a peace agreement, but only if all North Vietnamese troops are withdrawn from South Vietnam. The sources said that in a letter to President Nixon, Thieu said he is ready to make concessions on the makeup of a National Council of Reconciliation and Concord, which would set up elections to decide the future government of South Vietnam. Thieu thus appeared to be giving way on one of the main points he has contested in the draft peace agreement between Washington and Hanoi, while standing his ground on what he sees as the most important point, the withdrawal of North Vietnamese forces. A group which counsels conscientious objectors has interpreted a memorandum indicating the Defense Department intends to end the practice of granting honorable discharges to servicemen who oppose war. It would do so by giving base commanders authority to decide the status of conscientious objectors. The net result would give commanding officers the option of placing conscientious objectors on a non-combatant status rather than clogging military courts with the cases of servicemen seeking release from active duty because of their anti-war beliefs. Anti-war servicemen still would be able to appeal an adverse decision to civilian courts. Communist leaders from around the world gathered in Moscow today to herald the 50th anniversary of the Soviet Union. The speeches from North Vietnamese, Hungarian, Czechoslovak, Bulgarian, and Cuban leaders condemned American bombing of Hanoi, lauded Soviet achievements, and expressed gratitude for Soviet aid. In Paris, North Vietnamese diplomats asked for support and aid from all brothers and friends in the five continents. The appeal specifically asked the Soviet Union, China, and the American people to, quoting now, stop the criminal hands of the Nixon administration in time. This word just in, former President Harry Truman's heartbeat is irregular, his blood pressure has fallen, and he slipped into unconsciousness today. Doctors now report that his condition is somewhat worse than it was last night at this time. A spokesman at Research Hospital in Kansas City, Missouri says, quoting now, he is very close to critical at any time. Truman's wife, Bess, made a rare night visit at his bedside. In other news, with only 1 week remaining in 1972, the administration has little hope of keeping its promise to slow the inflation spiral by the end of the year. The cost of living edged up another 0.2% last month. The Bureau of Labor Statistics said in its monthly report today that food prices, which normally decline in November, actually jumped by 0.5%. The cost of winter clothing and gas for heating and cooking also went up, and while the cost of some commodities was down, namely gasoline and tires, the decline was not enough to offset an overall increase in the price index. The administration found little cheer in any of its own figures to counteract the Labor Department announcement. Herbert Stein, chairman of President Nixon's Council of Economic Advisers, put it clearly, inflation remains a national problem. Tests have been prepared for the orange moon rocks found by the three Apollo 17 astronauts on the moon. A spokesman comments from the Manned Space Center now in Houston.
Both sample return containers brought back Thursday morning are now being held in nitrogen cabinets while a scientific planning team discusses possible investigations to be undertaken immediately after opening. Apollo lunar sample return container number 2, which contains the orange rock found at Shorty Crater during the second lunar field trip, will be open Wednesday morning with the other Apollo lunar sample return container held for an additional week. Among the tests to be performed immediately after the vacuum-sealed stainless steel rock box is open is a gas analysis test. Initial chemical tests will aid planners in deciding which principal investigators will receive samples of the orange rock.
Not only the mail, but a lot of homeward-bound Americans may not get on time before Christmas. Across much of the country, snow, rain, and fog are hindering holiday travel. Along the East Coast, strong winds and high tides are reported. The West Coast is braced for an approaching Pacific storm, which threatens renewed flooding. In London, more than 500 Americans on their way home for the holidays are stranded. British airport authorities have begun a crackdown on illegal charter flights. Postmaster General Elmer Claussen reports that mail volume has reached a record high again this year. Claussen says 10 billion pieces of mail have been processed since the season began on November 27th, about 6% more than last year. Claussen confidently predicts that the mail will get through on time despite the bad weather. The National Safety Council doesn't have as optimistic a forecast for holiday motorists. The council says that between 7 a.m. today, our time, and midnight Monday, between 550 and 650 persons will die in traffic accidents. Another 26,000 to 30,000 persons may be injured. Finally in the news, Irving Berlin has given to the Smithsonian Institute the old upright piano on which he composed A White Christmas and Easter Parade. Berlin, now 84 years old, said today that the scarred mahogany piano is a Christmas gift to the Smithsonian. That's news. I'll be back with sports after this word.
And then there's the story about Sergeant Wilson. A real estate agent told him on the phone that he had a two-bedroom house for rent.
Air Force Sergeant Jeff Hopwood reporting. Paul Harvey follows this word.
You don't think of danger in a bank unless you're the bank guard. Then you can spot a problem almost before it happens. Just a typewriter. There are warning signals in everyday living. Learn to spot them. Like cancer's warning signals. It makes sense. For a free list of the warning signals, contact your American Cancer Society.
This is Paul Harvey. Stand by for news. Now, this next is going to be the rest of the story when it unfolds. 2 months ago, a military plane crashed in the snow-covered Andes Mountains. An Uruguayan military plane, 47 aboard, went down in the snow-covered Andes 2 months ago, and there are survivors. Maybe more than a dozen lived through this. It was a Fairchild turboprop. Passengers included a rugby team from Montevideo. Search planes searched for weeks and then gave up, and the search was called off until two survivors came out of the mountains on foot. Now, inevitably, however astronomically odd, a miracle like this always revives the hopes of any woman with a loved one missing under similar circumstances, such as our two congressmen missing and unfound in Alaska. 6% money is back. New York's big banks first to re-raise their prime rate. Consumer prices up again in November, but 0.2% was the least monthly increase since August, and 2/3 of that increase reflected higher food prices. And President Nixon has suspended quotas on meat imports for 1973, hoping to bring in enough meat from 14 other countries to drive grocery store meat prices down. In Kansas City, former President Harry Truman suffered a setback this morning. Heartbeat and blood pressure were severely depressed. Mrs. Truman was summoned to the bedside during the worst of it. Jimmy Wallington is dead, one of the superstar radio announcers of the 30s and 40s, announced Eddie Cantor and Fred Allen for many years. Jimmy Wallington was 64. And in Dallas, Texas, Joe Dealey, president of the prestigious Dallas Morning News, has paid $250,000 ransom to the kidnappers of his daughter-in-law. Amanda Dealey, 22, was held 2.5 days during the back-and-forth phone calls, but is home safe. Dealey married debutante Mandy just 6 weeks ago, big wedding, Jamaica honeymoon. She was abducted from their apartment last Tuesday. Dealey said the kidnappers used some foul language on the phone, implied some terrifying threats, demanded that he do nothing until he heard from them, so he said he didn't, said he just stayed in his apartment by the phone and did a lot of praying. Like on my knees, end quote. President Nixon, at the Florida White House, has a letter from President Tu of South Vietnam, a letter hand-delivered by General Haig this morning. President Nixon had threatened to cut off all aid, military and economic, to South Vietnam unless Tu agreed to agree to any Washington-Hanoi peace terms. Well, this letter is President Tu's reply to that ultimatum, and I do not yet know what it says, but in Saigon, a newspaper which President Tu controls says that he has changed his position on an important point, that Tu is now willing to abandon his demand for withdrawal of all North Vietnamese troops from South Vietnam, if North Vietnam will recognize South Vietnam as a separate state. So now we'll see. Sindlinger's survey shows Americans 67% behind President Nixon in this, that he should not sign an unworkable peace treaty. Meanwhile, our pulverizing of the Hanoi Haiphong area of North Vietnam continues without let up. Airline stewardesses, quite properly resentful of being categorized as off-duty playgirls, are resisting the image with a counterattack. Stewardesses now categorizing passengers, and there's one group they call polecats. A polecat passenger is characterized as follows. He wears a dry cleaner's phony handkerchief in his breast pocket. His socks sag around the ankles, white or argyle. The talon on his zipper protrudes. He demands a double scotch before takeoff, and he insists on talking to his seat companion, who may not want to. And he's a Casanova. And when the stewardess is unimpressed with his romantic suggestions, he leaves the plane determined to get even by spreading unbecoming stewardess stories.
fire announcement has been amended. Good afternoon. It's 2 o'clock. Here's a summary of the latest world news. The Saigon government has amended its earlier announcement of a Christmas ceasefire. The government says it is now considering when the ceasefire will start and how long it will last. Earlier, the ceasefire was announced for noon today, Saigon time. There's been no reason given for the reconsideration. The Viet Cong have also announced a ceasefire for the same period as the earlier Saigon announcement, and the Viet Cong say they'll observe a unilateral New Year's truce next week. Meanwhile, no official word as to whether the U.S. will halt the bombing of North Vietnam during the two ceasefire periods. The U.S. command now admits to 10, but Hanoi says 11 B-52s have been shot down over North Vietnam in 6 consecutive days of stepped-up air attacks, and the bombings continue. At least 55 Americans are listed by the command as missing, and the figure may run as high as 57. An apparent language problem has developed, meanwhile, between the Pentagon in Washington and the U.S. command in Saigon. The command says there will be no more reports on the number of crewmen aboard planes that are shot down. The Pentagon says there never were any reports issued on missing crew members aboard shot down planes. Officials of 5 national labor unions have called on President Nixon to sign an agreement to end the Vietnam War. They've also called for a Senate probe into the reasons why a peace agreement has not been reached. Among those labor leaders were representatives of the United Auto Workers and the Teamsters Union. Federal agents in Baltimore say an 8-year-old heroin smuggling ring has transported heroin from Vietnam into the U.S. with the dead bodies of GIs. This comes as a grand jury investigation continues. Holiday plans for some long-distance travelers in the U.S. have yet to get off the ground.
Just for the record, Parrish Song is the name of our ship, our call sign. Skip Rope is our boss. He's on another ship.
Starting computer checks.
1,800, sir.
What the hurry up and shoot? What are you waiting for?
Shoot. Getting lined up. Be a couple minutes, about 30 seconds.
How about on the skip rope?
Hot set. One gun, five salvo, shoot.
First time familiar
with this
situation. I understand that I should use
One gun, five salvo, shoot. Computer checks.
Next target, target 10.
Plot set.
Yeah.
One gun, 5 solids, shoot.
Passing 200, sir. Houseman I.
$25,800. $17,400. And $10,000.
You got something in the water about 200. Right, about 1,000 yards. Man. Well, can you see it? Alright. Yeah, I'll check it out, make sure.
Okay. Navigation holds target bearing 228 degrees true at 17,100.
Alright.
Captain, the Rupertus is going to go shopping now. Station Romeo as soon as possible.
Number one of the second group, sir.
Yeah, okay.
This is the one VC and AC, right?
Right, fly to AC.
Okay, diary. We'll have to order these in two. Let's check the fly check. They don't care.
One gun, 10 salvo.
Bombs actually are.
Geez, I don't know. I wonder if it's B-52s dropping them or what. They're shooting at them.
Packing a punch, I know that.
Must be something flying low enough they can shoot at.
Really? They're shooting at them?
Yeah, well, they ain't sitting there shooting faces, right?
Yeah. I see them going up in the air, I know that. Saw them? Huh? You turn your head and they came up again.
I watched it one time. It was really sickening.
With the bombs, you mean?
Yeah, yeah. How could man treat himself like that? It's just one line of fire on the horizon, you know? It's just a line of flames and explosions. It's just glowing.
Sometimes we do some damage. You can tell that from the secondary explosions, but most of the time all we're doing is killing time. I think it's a waste of time. This place gets old after about 2 days.
I know. Indeed, the helm. Steering 045, checking 050. And then 1/3, 022 revolutions for 3 knots.
Yeah, very well done.
What do you think about the war, Hawkins?
One. 19,200 yards, 3 feet and 6 inches.
On my mark, starting there. 14,500.
Block set.
Ready, 2-4.
All set.
Right, the fire over.
Fire out.
One gun, 2 salvos. Shoot.
Hey, Chief. Drop 800.
Sir. All
right, Sango. Roger, disregard.
100 left, 100.
Hey, tell them we can see the splashes on the beach, sir.
Salvos, fire for effect.
One gun, that's 10 salvos, fire for effect.
Roger.
Fired 100, over.
Check fire.
One gun, 10 salvos. Fire for effect. Shoot. What's the hold up? Gun target line 244.
Sir, your shots are way to the left of the target, about 500 meters.
Right. 70, are you saying you want those rounds in the same place?
Sir, okay, let's go right 500, over.
All right, 500.
One gun, 10 salvos, 5 for effect.
left 50.
Mary Sun around, clear.
Roger,
clear. Left. Would you give me that left 50 spot, over?
I'm sorry.
All right.
Okay. One gun, 5 salvo, shoot.
One gun, fire, 5 salvos, fire for effect, shoot.
Shut up.
Flash, over.
Flash, on. Power for miles. Your arms move about 400 meters, left, over.
Then move to the left about 400 meters, huh?
Roger, okay, and then?
Right 200, that chance.
You moved into the tree line. I counted 5 or 6 of them before you moved into the tree line. Plus, you might have the spotter check it out for us. Time to play, 25 seconds.
Ready, 25.
Roger, ready.
One gun, 5 salvos, 5 for effect, shoot.
Shot.
Shut up.
Then charge line 243.
One gun, 2 salvos, right 200, over.
One gun, 2 salvos, right 200, out.
One gun, 2 salvos, fire.
Shut up.
Round complete, turn out.
They were in the mission. Target covered.
In the mission, target covered. Every song, 50 rounds expected, over.
50 rounds?
That's our song, affirm.
Not 30 or 20.
That's our song, that's the negative, it's 50.
31508, target number 041425. Direction, gun target 9, target elevation, 258. Target still shift, now 2-1-3, 2-5 areas, 1-2-3, 2-5, light command, just fire.
Grid, 3-5, gun target line, target elevation, 2-5 feet, target description, troops, bunkers, supply area, 1 gun, 2 salvo, that my command, adjust fire, over.
Sorry,
that last spot you gave me, that
take effect,
all right, over.
$4,000. $4,000. $4,000. $4,000. $4,000. $4,000.
Years register,
and listen, man. You know, when somebody...
Change
her.
Okay. Rather than that, we'll find out if there's any more spiders around that we can use.
Target there.
What, the 9 or 2, 3 quarters? 7,220. Stand by. Watch this, though,
please. Watch that.
Number 192 and 3/4.
Yes, sir.
Flight control,
we're
switching to
target
number 1.
Stand by for doing
so.
Here's your flight control transfer. You're
male, 2. One gun, 5 salvos, 5 perfect. Shoot.
Flash, over.
Flashdown. General quarters, general quarters. All hands man your battle stations.
Two-thirds.
Two-thirds.
Very well.